हेलो फ्रेंड्स, स्टूडेंट्स, प्रोफेशनल्स एंड टीचर्स, मायसेल्फ प्रदीप परमार, लेक्चरर इन इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, पॉलिटेक्निक द महाराजा सयाजीराव यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ बड़ौदा. हियर आई एम ट्राइंग टू टीच समथिंग अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट. नाउ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मीन्स नॉट ओनली इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कंपोनेंट्स, बट इट कवर्स मैनी टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रो कंट्रोलर्स, माइक्रो प्रोसेसर्स, DSPs, and many more things. These are the steps of electronics project development. First step is title. You have to give appropriate title which reflects actual application of the project. Second step is technology. Nowadays there are thousands of choices of everything. Now the main part in your project is the processing unit. So which processing unit you are going to use? Microcontroller, microprocessor, DSP, or a ready-made board like Arduino or Raspberry Pi? So that you have to specify in this section. Other supporting items like display, keyboard, memory, either onboard memory or external memory, then communication technology like Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, external interface like USB or anything else. So that everything you have to specify in this section. Then features. So here you have to list out features you are going to give in your project. This can be comparative also. So you can give a comparison with any existing product or project. And which additional features you are going to give in your project, that must be highlighted, and that is very important. Then specifications. Now there is a difference between features and specifications. Features gives idea about functionality of your project, whereas specifications gives idea about performance of your project. For example, you can specify speed of your processing unit, resolution of display, resolution of ADC if you are going to use, speed of communication, and other things are also there that you can specify in this section. Then feasibility. Feasibility means whatever we design on paper and on computer, that should be implementable practically. Or in other words, we can say that our product should be sellable in the market and should be accepted by the people. Now the most important step in electronics project development is hardware designing. Hardware designing can be divided in three steps. First is design of schematic circuit diagram. Second is design of printed circuit board. And third is generation of bill of material. Once hardware design is ready, we have to check several things before going ahead. We have to check the components listed in our final bill of material, whether they are available in the market and at which cost. And finally, we should prepare an Excel sheet to calculate the total cost of the project. If we find any difficulty or problem regarding availability of the component or its cost, then here we have chance to change that particular component by its equivalent component. Next step is firmware programming. Firmware programming is the programming of our main processing unit, and for that we have to use a particular studio, or you can say IDE, its full form is Integrated Development Environment. So in which we have to write the code in particular language. Now, widely used language is Embedded C. For most of the microcontrollers, Embedded C is used. But if our processing unit is special type like Raspberry Pi, then we can write the program in Python language also. Now, next two steps, software programming and mobile application programming, are optional. So that depends on requirement of user. If user needs graphical user interface type of control, then we have to build a software in a particular platform like Java. And if mobile application is also required, then we have to build an application for Android or Apple, depending on user's requirement. Once everything is ready, hardware is designed, firmware is programmed, and software or applications are also built, then we can go for prototyping. It is nothing but first copy of our product. And the last step is enclosure design. This also depends on user's requirement. So according to user's requirement, we have to design the enclosure. Here also we can hire a third party. So this is all about electronics project development. But this is only introduction. We will see all the steps in detail in next videos. If you like this video and want to watch another videos, then please like this video, subscribe our channel and give comments. Thank you very much for watching this video. Good day and goodbye.